Thanks for listening to this lesson introduction on Daniel chapter 4, God is sovereign. The big idea in this lesson is clear. Man is not sovereign, God is. Imagine for a moment that you heard the most powerful political figure in the world give his or her personal testimony of faith in God. What would be your reaction? Has that ever happened in history? The answer is yes. Daniel chapter 4 is a record of King Nebuchadnezzar's testimony of true believing faith in God. You may remember that in chapter 2, he made a declaration that said, quote, "Truly, your God is the God of gods, the Lord of kings," end quote. But in chapter 4, his words are entirely different. The big idea here is that God, not man, is sovereign. Nebuchadnezzar testified to this truth in a powerful way. In Daniel chapter 4, verse 1, the Bible says, quote, "To all people, nations, and languages that dwell on earth," end quote. And then he goes on to tell how God humbled him so he could learn that God, not him, is sovereign over all. Every person who has lived, is living now, or will live on earth must come to understand this truth before they die. That's the big idea. If I was leading this lesson, here is how I would approach it. While all 16 questions are important, I'd focus on questions 2, 3, 6, and 10. There are some very helpful and practical questions in this lesson and in every lesson, so let me show you the best way to handle them. When you come to a personal question such as 4B or 6B, there's a couple things you should remember. First, don't just skip over a practical question by saying something like this. Our next question is a personal question, so let's all consider how it applies to our lives. In essence, you're just avoiding the question. If you do this, the group participants will soon do the same, and the question's impact will be lost. Secondly, don't force the participants to share their answers in a group setting. Doing so may make them not want to come back to the group. Now may God bless your desire to minister God's word to your group members. I hope this introduction will enable you to lead in such a way that He is glorified and lives are changed forever into the image of Jesus Christ.